In this video, we're going to look at what's new with the Notes app on the iPhone with iOS 18. Now, if you find this video helpful, stick around to the end. I'll tell you a little bit more about myself and how you can help support my efforts in creating these videos. All right, let's take a look at what's new with the Notes app on the iPhone with iOS 18. Let's go over to my iPhone. So I'm using an iPhone 15 here, and it is running iOS 18. Now, being that it is an iPhone 15, it can run Apple Intelligence, but I do have that turned off. So I'm going to go over here, and you're going to see that it is turned off. So most of the features that I'm going to show you that are new in the Notes app do not require Apple Intelligence. There is one feature that I will show you towards the end that does require Apple Intelligence. So I'm going to come back in here and turn this on later on. So now let's go back over to my Notes app. So I'm going to open up the Notes app here. The first thing that we're going to look at is collapsible sections. So what I need to do is I need to go and create a new note. I tap on the note here. And if you're not familiar with how Notes works, the first sentence that you type up here is going to be the title of the note. Makes it really easy to title the note. So I'm just going to call this is the title. Real creative here. Now, being that this is the title, what it does is it automatically changes this next paragraph into the body. And this will come into play when I show you how collapsible sections work. So now what I'm going to do is I'm just going to type in here topic, because this is going to be the topic. This is the headline that I want to be collapsible. But right now it is just a body. And when I hit return, I'm going to call this one line one, and we're going to go line two. So now we have my topic and two lines underneath it. So what I'd like to do is I would like to make topic be collapsible. The way that we do that is we have to change the style. Remember how I said that this is a title style? And then if you keep typing, what it does is it changes it into a body style. Well, if we change that out of a body style and make it back into a title style or a heading style or a subheader style, what it does is it makes it collapsible. So how do we do that? Well, basically, we just place our cursor in that line. So I'm going to place the cursor right here in topic. So I just tap on it. We can see the cursor is there blinking. Now, all I need to do is just go over to my style options here. And if I tap on subheading or heading here, what it'll do is it'll make it collapsible. I can even go and swipe to the right and make it into a title. So let's just go ahead and make this into a heading. So I tap on heading here. And now we can see that that is slightly larger than the line one and line two. It is also collapsible. How do I know that? Well, basically all I need to do is just tap over in this area here. And when I do, you're going to see that over to the left, there's this little caret here and it is pointing down. That's because that is open. This is the collapsible section. So when I tap on that caret that is pointing down to close it, I tap on it. Now it is going to be pointing to the right, and you're going to see that those two lines are no longer there. I want to open it back up. All it is doing is just hiding those. All I have to do is just tap on that little caret again, and when I do, it opens it back up. So all we need to do is just tap on title, heading, or subheading, and it'll make it collapsible. If we no longer want it to be collapsible, then what we need to do is we need to change it back into the body, and then it will no longer be collapsible. So that's how we make collapsible sections. In addition to that, we can also highlight text. So let's say I wanted to change the color of line two here. In order to do that, we first have to select the text. Let's just go ahead and close my styling here so we're starting fresh. And I select the text, I just double tap on it, and we can see that it is selected there. And then we need to go back over to our styling here, where we can go and change it into a title or a header. Well, there's going to be a new option there with iOS 18, and that is highlight. When I tap on that purple dot, what I'm able to do is select the color that I want to change it to. So let's just keep it with purple here. I tap on purple, and now we can see that that text is purple. To remove that highlighting, again, we just select it. So I have it selected. And then all we have to do is just tap on this icon here and it'll remove it. and now it is no longer highlighted. So that's how we can easily highlight our text. Now let's take a look at transcription. We can use the Notes app for live audio transcription. Basically, what we can do is we can have it record. Maybe you're at a lecture or something and you want to record it. You can record it right in the Notes app and it'll transcribe it for you. To do that, what we need to do is we need to go over to the little paperclip here. When I tap on the paperclip, you're going to see that I have the option to record audio. And again, this does not require Apple Intelligence. Remember, I have Apple Intelligence off. So as far as I know, this doesn't require Apple Intelligence. So I just tap on record audio, and when I do, what it's going to do is change the interface. A little card is going to come up, and then all I have to do is just tap on record. So I'm going to tap on record, and I'm just going to say something here, and you're going to see that what it'll do is it'll transcribe it for me. So I'm going to tap on record. Record audio sessions within your note and generate live audio transcriptions you can search through or combine with other comments, checklists, or documents. I tap on the pause here to pause it. Once it is paused, I'm able to close it. So now I have that recording. Tap on done, and look what we have here. I have the recording, and I can play it. But in addition to that, I also have a transcription. So when I tap on this, I can actually view that transcription. So this is great if you're at a lecture or at some kind of a presentation and you want to record it. You can now use the Notes app to do that. And when you do that, it'll also transcribe it. Now let's take a look at Math Notes. With Math Notes, what we're able to do is type out formulas within the Notes app. Let's see what I mean. So to do this, what we need to do is we need to go into our drawing tool because we're going to just draw a formula. So I tap on the drawing tool, and right now I could just type some text or draw some text or anything like that. But this time what we're going to do is we're just going to draw a formula. I'm just going to go 2 plus 2. We'll keep it really simple. So I go 2 plus 2 equals. And when we do that, you're going to see that it's going to solve it. So I just tap on solve, and now we can see it came back with 4, the answer. In addition to that, we can easily change some of these numbers. Let's go and say that I didn't mean to have a 2 here. I wanted to have a 4 there. Well, all I have to do is just tap on it, and you're going to see that we have this little slider here. And then all I have to do is just slide to the left or right, or I should say right to left there, and it'll change that number. So I'm just going to go ahead and swipe to the left and right, and look at that number. You're going to see that it is changing. Not only is the number changing, but the answer is changing as well. So it's computing that on the fly based on my handwriting there. Now I'm doing just a real simple formula here, but you could really get complicated with these formulas. And if I wanted to change this one here, I can do that too. I tap on it, and again, I can go and change it. So we can now easily enter formulas and even change them within the Notes app. And it'll save this. If I close this note, it'll save it. So that's our Math Notes. Now the next feature I'm going to show you requires Apple Intelligence. Basically what we're able to do is clean up our text. If I were to write something out, we can have it clean it up. So I need to go back to my iPhone and turn on Apple Intelligence. So I'm going to swipe up here a little bit. We're going to go over to Apple Intelligence. I tap on it to turn it on. And now we need to go back over to my Notes app. So I'm going to swipe up here a little bit and we're looking at my notes. So now let's just go and handwrite something in here. So I'm going to swipe up here a little bit and we're going to go into this area here and I'm just going to type something out or write something out. How do we do that? We just go to our little pen tool here where we can draw. And being that we're drawing, I can draw out letters. So I'm just going to type in there or write in there, hello. So I just go and hello. And you can see that it is not that great. My handwriting is not that great. So what I need to do is I need to have the iPhone or the Notes app clean this up. How do we do that? Well, basically, we just have to select it, and then we can refine it. And Apple Intelligence will go and clean that up. It's still going to be in the handwriting, not necessarily my handwriting, but it is still going to be in handwriting. And being that this is in cursive, it'll keep it in cursive. If it was in print, it'd be in print. So I tap on done. This is the easiest way that I found it. We need to deselect everything so nothing is selected. And then I just select this. To select it, I double tap on it. We can see that it is selected. Now what I need to do is I need to refine this. So how do we refine it? Well, basically I just long press on it and you're going to see we have a little pop-up menu. And when I tap on the arrow here to the right, we're going to have the option to refine it. So now when I tap on refine here, what it's going to do is it's going to refine that. And you can see that it refined it. Still in script or cursive, but it is now refined and cleaned up. And it is actually at a slight angle here. What we can do is we can straighten it. So then it is straight. I should have written it a little bit more at an angle, but basically what we are able to do is straighten it. So how do we do that? Well, we just long press on it again to get to that little menu. I tap on this, and then you're going to see the option to straighten it. So if this was at an angle like that, what it would do is it would straighten it out. So let's go ahead and straighten. You're going to see that this is just going to move down slightly. So I tap on straighten, and it moved down slightly. So we can even straighten our text if we wrote it at an angle. If we had a typo in there, it would also allow us to correct the typo. It knows what words we're putting in there, and it'll just change letters and put them in the proper script here and correct your spelling. So you could mistype a word in there as well. And in handwriting, it'll go and refine it and correct your spelling. Now, the last thing I want to show you also involves Apple Intelligence. Not only can we have it refine text, but we can also have it rewrite our text. It can give us a summary. It can rewrite it. It can make it more friendly, more concise. So how do we do that? Well, basically, we just have to go to some text. So I'm going to swipe down here, and we're going to actually go over to this text here that it transcribed. So I tap on it. And now what we need to do is we just need to select it. So I select it here. And when we do that, you're going to see that I have a little pop-up menu that's called Writing Tools. And when I tap on that, what I'm able to do is proofread this. So to look for any errors in there. I can also rewrite it, and I can change the tone of it. I can make it friendly, professional, concise. And then I can also add tables or key points in there. Swipe up here a little bit, and you're going to see that we have summary, key points, list, and table. I just tap on any one of those to use Apple Intelligence to rewrite it. Now, this is within a transcription, but we can also do that. Let's go ahead and get out of here. We can also do that right from within the note. And it's a little bit easier when you're in the note. So I'm going to go and tap on my topic here. And now when I do that, the keyboard pops up and you're going to see we have this little icon here. This little icon also brings us back over to where we have our writing tools, which is all Apple Intelligence. So those are the two ways that you can get to Apple Intelligence writing tools. You can select the text, use a pop-up menu, or what you can do when you're in the note is you can tap on the little Apple Intelligence icon. So that is what is new with the Notes app on the iPhone with iOS 18. Most of the features do not require Apple Intelligence. We can create collapsible sections. We can highlight text, basically change the color of it. We can also record audio and create transcripts from it. And we have our math notes. In addition to that, if you have a newer iPhone that supports Apple Intelligence, you can also clean up your text, refine your text, I should say. And you can use writing tools to proofread your text, rewrite the text, or even change the tone of it. So that is what is new with the Notes app on the iPhone with iOS 18. Now, if you found this video helpful, what you may want to do is like the video. You can subscribe to my channel. You can share it with your friends and family. In addition to that, you may want to check out danstutorials.com. Although I do have over 400 videos as of this recording on YouTube, I have a lot more on my site, danstutorials.com. So how can you help support my efforts? Well, Dan's Tutorials is a membership-based site. So when you become a member of my site, I take out all of the ads of the videos. You also have access to an AI assistant modeled after an Apple Genius. And then you have access to my classes and webinars that I hold on a regular basis. In addition to that, you're also helping support a small business. It is just me in a corner office of my house and a spare bedroom that I turned into a studio. So when you become a member, you are directly supporting my efforts in creating these videos. Check out Dan's Tutorials for more information, and thanks for watching.